today we've got Morgan in, and she loves my nails, but she kind of wanted a pink version. So that's what we're going to do. My nails are a little bit battered because I've been doing everybody else's nails and I have filed them a little bit, shall we say. A lot. So we're going to keep this colour in the background. So this is an acrygel that we've got. It is the Aurora from Nailchemy. And it's got like a little bit of sparkle in. And I think that'll look nice as a background colour for the French, especially. I'm just going to wipe over with clean-up solution because just in case that client has been touching a face or putting a finger in a mouth or, you know, anywhere like that, a nose. Because these are acrygel and they're really, really porous, they don't need a base coat on, which is pretty cool. But we're going to use Mercury, and I'll need my little palette because of the wonderful things he does. So we're going to put a little bit of Mercury onto the palette, and we'll need the Lily Liner Brush. And the Lily Liner Brush is going to help us to create a beautiful smile line. And this is highly pigmented silver metallic. It's called Mercury, and we only need one coat of this. So if you're wondering whose hands these are, they're Morgan's.
I don't.
Morgan the Great. She's here for all your fashion desires. So we're drawing in the smile line first on this one, just because it's such a big nail. I mean, I'm saying it's such a big nail. Morgan has tiny nails, but this is probably like a middle finger or a ring finger on a normal person.
I do have mini nails.
You've got mini, mini nails. So I'm just going to get that nice and neat, and then I'm going to come in with the brush from the bottle. Or you can do like I did on the other ones and do the brush from the bottle and then go in with the brush, with the Lily Liner Brush. I just felt like I needed to do that smile line first with that one. And then we're going to use the flash gel. So this is from the Crushed Diamonds collection, and it's one of our flash gels called Yasmin. So it's got a bunch of reflective glitter in. So when the flash comes on, they go pew. They look so nice. I think they're like extra sparkly. So we're going to do a layer of that. And I think this over the top of Mercury just like really intensifies the silver. Because she wants some pink, because I bet you're thinking, you've used silver, what's going on? But she wants some pink. We're going to change the colour. We're not going to take it all off and change, you know, and do it again. We're going to change the colour with Party Pool, which is one of our jelly top coats, and it's the pink jelly top coat. So you can use the coloured jelly top coats to change the colour of this glitter. And there's loads of different colours. And then you want your edging in
white.
So we're doing this first, then we'll do the white. Because if we did the white and then we put this over, oh dear, we would have pink lines. And again, I'm going to use the Lily Liner Brush to go over the silver around that smile line. Just pop me them in the lamp for a sec. Right, because this is top coat and I'm going to put white gel polish on top, I just need to make sure the areas that I am putting the gel polish are slightly abrased, because it will really stick then. See, shiny on shiny doesn't always work. So I'm just buffing around that area. Very lightly. I'm going to wipe over with the clean-up solution to get rid of the dust. So, the white is called White Out. I definitely need a new bottle. I use it so much. Let me just make sure there's no gel in this brush. So you'll notice I pulled through some gel first, then cleaned my brush with the gel. And that makes sure there's no colour in this brush from a previous set. So we're going to frame the smile line. Now, I did this using my non-dominant hand. And it was tricky. But the good thing is, you know, if you do mess up, you can just wipe it off and start again. Yeah.
put me that in the lamp.
So make sure you don't flood the cuticle. So using the lily liner brush will help that because it's so small. Right, with this one, we're going to do a moon. So notice how my hands are resting on each other. That will help steady you.
In the lamp.
So we're going to get some gem glue out, which is the crystal Totalis from Nailchemy. And I need my Pammy picker-upper. And I'm going to use the design needle end of the Pammy picker-upper to pick up my gel and put that where I want it. So I'm going around the outside with the smaller ones, and what that'll do, it will also protect that big stone. Kind of adds like a bumper. Get some micro beads. You have to have a bit. The clients always do that. They just want to look all the bloody time. You can look at them for like another 4 weeks stuck. So what are we going to do about this one now?
What one?
That one's got no gems on.
Yeah, but it's got a half moon.
So you're happy with that? Oh, she's examining them now. Are you happy with that?
I thought it was. Yeah? Until you said that.
I'm going to have trouble looking at them.
Oh, okay. Shouldn't have said anything. Shouldn't have said anything.
Do you know what, though? Recently I've been scrolling. I haven't seen any nails that have, like, popped out at me. You know, you just see them on, like, socials and you think, oh, I like that, I like that. I've not really seen any. I don't know if it's because they're all Christmas.
Yeah.
I'm not into the seasonal nails.
I aren't either, really.
Like the Halloween, not for me.
I like Halloween nails.
Not on myself.
Not on yourself?
No, because like personal preference, they're not going to match my outfits.
No, I suppose not.
I'm not saying I don't like the designs.
Yeah, but they're not what sort you would wear. You can appreciate the designs, but you wouldn't wear them.
They'd have to be a press-on, dog.
Yeah.
Press-on, fling off.
Press on, fling off. Oh my god.
Like Christmas nails are great for a day, aren't they?
This is my point. Pop them in the lamp. I know it's not Christmas anymore, by the way. When we film this, it's like days before Christmas. I like looking at certain aspects of Christmas nails, but I'm not a fan of Christmas nails. For me to do Christmas nails on this channel is a struggle. Like, I enjoy doing the Grinch nails.
Yeah, stuff like that is fun.
Because that was fun, and it was very much how I feel about Christmas.
Yeah.
But, no, I just don't like...
It's not for me,
huh? No, I don't like Christmas nails.
No.
It's not a nice theme, is it?
No.
It's just red, green and gold.
Yeah, no. I like Halloween because I can go a bit crazy. I do really like Halloween stuff. But Christmas, no. Easter, I'm going to struggle with Easter ones, to be honest.
Valentine's, we can sometimes make it work.
Yeah.
Hearts and all that, you know.
But I'm not keen on themes like that.
No.
So we're going to top coat these now. Make sure you go right to those edges and you let that brush run under the nail like that, because you need to seal in that white border. And with your stones, these crystals, make sure you push your top coat up to it. So don't go over them. Just let it just kiss the sides of the stones. Oh, look. Now, what I like to do, especially when I've been doing quite a bit of layering, I like to get the metal file and just make sure that those sections right at the edges, so that little bit there has no, like, overlapping gel, because sometimes that top coat can kind of run. And we want to make sure that's not on the skin. It's not going to create an area where your client could potentially sit and pick at. You want no pick and flick areas.
They are. Look, they're a different version.
Twinning duck.
Twinning? We're twinning. Sort of. An alternative version.
She's not an identical twin.
No, she's not identical. She wanted the same sack. But I like them. I want to see what they like with the flash on. Oh, wow.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Gorgeous.
Oh, check out the flash gel. That is insane. Stunning. Oh, there you are, guys. An alternative version of my nails. Which ones do you like more? I quite like yours now. I can need more stones.
I think they're both different.
Yeah.
Even though they're the same.
Yeah, I think if I had my pink in my hair, I'd have to have them. If I had the pink in my hair.
Now you're the ice queen.
Now I'm the ice queen for a bit. Let's see how long I stay the ice queen for. So, you guys, everything I've used today will always be listed below. We have a bunch of discount codes down there as well. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video. Ta-ra, duck!